The store outside, never saw you came, and I don't know what this is that you can't send a human being text when I've been on very important calls, and now you're not answering the phone. I don't have time for all these games, Cameron. If you need me to meet you somewhere, tell me where in a text. I'm putting out some major fires right now. I should have been doing instead of sitting around with you two all day, as I kept begging you I had to go, and you guys kept saying no a little longer. Now help me before I have to go do other stuff that you're gonna force me into doing if this continues to escalate. I'm really trying to work with both of you. I really am. But now, you're starting to push my buttons the wrong way. So, text me if you don't get me, because I'm tired of calling and you're not answering. And I can't stop important phone calls with federal officials just because you have air across your ass. I'm trying to help you too. But you're not working with me on this, and if you guys don't, I have what I need to do to make it as crazy for you as you're making it for me. So knock it off and get to me now. I have no more patience for this, and I've got to get home and get work done tonight because you guys have caused me a major shitstorm today. Dude, I'm tired of being interrupted during federal calls because you have stuff that you want to talk about and you won't bother to even send a text. I don't know what's going on, but I don't have time for this. I waited at the store, you didn't show, so what's going on? The game needs to end now, or I'm going home to file the reports that I was going to file when you made me a promise that you're not keeping now. I'm fucking exhausted, so please, text me what you need so I can continue to put out fires until we meet. I have a major shitstorm I'm dealing with. Hello. fuck is going on here? Why aren't you guys answering your fucking phone? Tired of this. This is exhausting to me. I don't even have money for a motherfucking quarter. They told me that this matter was handled. The dope flood, and it was open. And I just come in, so I don't know what's happening. Okay, hold the check. Stop, stop, Sabrina. Call Sabrina. Where's Sabrina? Call her now. Sabrina, Joe, I just found out from Citibank, from Chase, when I went to deposit my check, they've closed it because of fraud that happened on the account with a new chip card, which I have no idea how it happened. They have no idea how it happened, but they've just decided to close, and so don't deposit the other check if you haven't already. If you have, I've already told them they're going to have to cover your expenses on that, because they made a decision to do that without notifying me whatsoever. So I'm going to try and find another way to either cash a check tonight or get to another place and get it cashed in the morning and bring you a cashier's check or cash or something. I'm sorting it out. I have the check to deposit, and I can't deposit it because I, to make sure it got in on time, I had them send me the check, and I went to pick it up to deposit it so it'd be in on time, as I discussed with your mom. Anyway, I'll call your mom to make sure you guys haven't deposited. Hi.
Hey, Joe, what's going on?
Don't deposit the other check if you haven't. Have you already tried to deposit it or not?
No.
Okay, yeah, hold the check. Hold, no, don't even deposit it. I just found out from Chase when I went to deposit the check, because I went and picked it up so I could deposit it, and they told me they closed the account because of the fraud that happened with the chip that I told you about. So I will either find a check cashing place tonight.
Okay.
Or I'll find one in the morning and I'll bring you cash. Don't even touch that check again. I told them they owe you a fee. They're going to cut me a check in 10 days. I told them they need to include a fee for a bounced check because I wrote it in good faith. You deposited in good faith, and there was no notification whatsoever. The account was closed, so I had no way to even warn you in time.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm really upset about this. I don't. It happened with a chip card. I can't control that, so I don't know what they're thinking. So my apologies, but I'll keep working on it until I get it sorted out. I do have the physical check from the feds. I just got to find somewhere to get a cash now.
Okay, I'll tell Sabrina.
Yeah, I left her a message also, but I wanted to make sure I talked to you. So
okay.
Thanks, buddy. Thanks for being on the scene. All right, bye. Oh, I'm ready to kill myself.
Relax.
I've had everybody hacking my bank accounts, AT&T. Everybody's screwing with every account I have on the planet.
Let me be clear about something.
I don't joke about this power. Okay, I hope we can work this out because I talked to a few people and told me this man was fixed. Please tell me they fixed it and you can find my account.
How are you today?
Exhausted.
Do you want some water?
Hi. No, thanks. Yeah. I talked with corporate and they said that it's unlocked.
Yeah. Adam was on is on vacation. So
I found
that
out.
Yeah, he was supposed to.
But I called in and checked on the way driving in, and they said it's unlocked. If you're having a problem getting in, then it's something you need to talk to fraud department about.
Yeah, because I'm not sure what the resolution was. Cause at this
well,
end,
they told me it is resolved at corporate level, that you should be able to pull it up. They can see it and restrict it. 310. But this has all happened since I've seen you guys. And I don't know what point it became unrestricted, but when I was on the phone with her about an hour ago, she said it's unrestricted on her side. And that she was alerting fraud because she doesn't know how to unlock it for you guys. She can't help me help you. That's why they've been saying have you guys call in, because they have it unlocked, but they don't know how to fix it, so you can see it. Can you see it?
The number, you said the number 310?
925-2709. I'm not faulting you guys. I understand you got your hands tied, but this is just so exhausting.
Yeah, I got you. 310, sorry.
925-2709. Anything? Please work this time, please. Sorry, let's turn this. This is where we're in for a fucking year. Did it open?
No. No.
You're kidding me.
Give me 1 second, okay? Give me 1 second.
I'll be back. Yeah. Do you think it's going to be open or not? Because if not, I got to run to Best Buy before they close and try and buy a sim there. What's your gut saying?
I think your best bet is going through Best Buy, being that.
That's sim I need?
Yeah.
How much should it cost?
It should be only $25.
Fuck, yeah. I don't have one laying around you can give me. And now how do I get the service activated? Call back to the customer service line and have them turn it on?
Because at this point it's blocked and it's referring me to Cynthia Hennessy, which is the point of contact for your account at this point.
Is she in legal? Or in fraud?
It doesn't say.
Cynthia Hennessy. She might be her legal department. Seems that name sounds familiar. She's someone I think I've dealt with. I don't know.
I can give you her number and her. I have her email address.
Yeah, if you have something I can jot it.
Yeah. Over. So
I can put it in the phone.
I'll give you her email address and I'll see if I can locate her number, okay?
Yeah, or if you can also text me the number if you can't find it right immediately. Hang on, I can check real quick. What's her name again?
Cynthia Hennessy.
H-E-N-N-E-S-S-Y. Cynthia Hennessy is at your legal department. Yeah, I have her email address. That one?
Yeah, that's the.
Do you have a phone number? I don't have a way to reach her. Yeah, thanks. I mean, I've been trying. I don't understand how your customer service can keep saying it's open and come in. True, it's just that wouldn't have wasted so many fucking trips here if we would, you know, have systems to talk to each other. What a concept that would be for a big company. Do they always make this difficult, or did I just get the lucky in the ass?
I wish I could tell you, I've never seen it this difficult, but I'm not sure.
Well, I guess when you piss off Randall Stevenson's office, they take it personal. But maybe they shouldn't have contacted the Department of Justice on a breach that I told them about before they notified me. Man, that's a minor detail in comparison to some of the other dumb shit he's done. Breathe. I'm trying to breathe. I have begged with their offices for a year, almost, to fix billing on corporate accounts that they... I shouldn't bore you guys with these details, I'm sorry. I'm just so stressed from your company, I think I'm going to need therapy for the rest of my life. I've been traumatized by AT&T.
Number.
Oh boy, I'm so excited.
425?
Oh, so she's in Dallas. 425?
580.
Come on, phone. Catch up. 425-580.
It's
4738. Is that a direct?
Yes, yeah, sir. That looks like it's her work. The only
number
she has on file.
And that is a Dallas number, isn't it? 425?
I think so.
I think that sounds familiar,
yeah. Yeah, I mean, I used to live in Dallas 100 years ago, but it seems to me they added that area code. Yeah, that sounds right, because that's where your corporate's at anyway. Okay, tell Adam I appreciate his efforts, so he can't do anything on the DirecTV thing? Anything? Nothing?
Nothing.
And he's gone for 3 weeks now. So I somehow got to talk to this delightful individual that I've been communicating via email for months now who hasn't responded to me in months. And still pull this off before the billing cycle ends. When does the billing cycle end? When do they have me set to end? They keep moving the goddamn thing. I can't keep up with it. I've been begging just put it at the 5th and leave it alone, but I think it's now the 16th. That's why I became late again and why the account's still locked.
Yeah,
it's 16th. Yeah, okay. I'll go away now. Thanks. Fuck. Hey, I'm exhausted from this. Maybe they should just kill me and put me out of my misery. What do you think? It's truly not your fault. It's at your corporate level. But this has just been going on all my accounts with AT&T since the breach last September when somebody breached my VPN and they couldn't tell me how it happened, but I had 10,000 hits like in seconds and my computers were going to sites I've never seen, and your security department said, we didn't see any load. We don't know how they did it. But we called the FBI for you. Oh, well, thanks. And when you need to call them, they're expecting your call. Fabulous. Next time, could you at least discuss it before you throw me under a bus with the gov? Not your fault. I'm just stressed over this. Fuck. Yeah, I made it as quick as I could and went nowhere. They had me drive all the way across town to say no again. Thank you. One of these days I'll come and eat there. Truly my apology. I'll get a move for you, sir. Sorry about that. Thank you. Hennessy, this is Kurt Kelly. I would really like to resolve these matters. Could you pick up a phone and call me tomorrow so we don't have to go before a federal judge? 310-925-2709. I've been trying to mitigate with your company now since last year on corporate and other accounts and a lot of inappropriations that have happened. I think we should speak. Thank you. I expect your call tomorrow morning. Thank you. And if you miss me, please leave a message. Get the fuck out of here. You're going in? I can't get through. I gotta go that way. Are you going in? What are you doing? Fucking ass. Just there blocked it. Oh, now you're going through. You blocked the way.
Oh, dear Jesus. Relax. Let it go. You cannot expect the world to operate normal right now. It's not. Crap. Food, fear, terrorism, governments. It's an epic time in the big picture. Dude, I don't know why you're making this so difficult. I can't wait any longer at AT&T. My business is done. You need to talk to me, because I'm very ill. I'm exhausted, and I need to get moving back to the other side of town to put out other fires that happened as a result of me missing appointments today that I needed to keep. So please, since you're not answering your phone, text me where I can meet you right now, because I don't want to drive around all night waiting to hear back from you. I'm exhausted, and I have many other fires to put out. So please, be human with me and tell me where to meet you right now. Check cashing place, open near me. Do you cash government checks?
Yes.
Okay, where are you located?
On 3rd and La Cienega.
3rd? And what's your right to cash a... Hang on, I'll give you the amount here in 1 second. Hang on. Oh, God, where's the number here? 2224, $2,224. What's your fee to cash that? How much? Okay, and you're at 3rd and La Cienega on which corner, or can you give me the address, please?
Yeah. Is that recalling it
in
like 2 minutes?
Oh, no, that won't work. I'm in Westwood. Do you know anything else open later? What
but
part?
I don't have the exact address.
Normandy and 3rd. Do you know what part of town that's in?
By downtown.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're
24-hour check cashing near me. Dude, you're not returning my calls. You're not answering the phone when I call. I've called multiple times. I've left a couple of messages. I'm not hearing back from you. And you're not replying my text. What do you expect me to think at this point? Please, tell me. Because I'm exhausted and I really need to get on with other stuff. So where am I meeting you right now? Please give me an address. I don't know what's going on with you and Cameron, and I really am at the point I'm not sure I even care anymore because you guys have exhausted me beyond recognition. I kept saying I had to go and you guys kept staying and then dashed off very abruptly. Irregardless, I've been waiting to meet him now for quite some time on your side of town. I made it easy for him. But he's refusing to communicate via text, and I've called him several times, and I keep getting voicemail, and I've been on important calls when he's calling. So please get him to either call me immediately or text me an address where I can meet him now, because I don't have any more energy to wait. And if you continue to let this drag out, I'll just go file a police report. I'm exhausted. I can't do this anymore with you guys. Give me an answer what we're doing here. She's working on undertaking one of those steps. Let's get over all week. Oh, Jesus God. I'm sure glad I actually didn't bring Cameron and blow his identity. He's such a great guy. And what we talked about is of little consequence in the big picture of what's going on today and in my life at this split second. Oh, God, I have a headache from this. Okay. Absolutely, hell yes. Tired.